वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा साक्षात्कृतं दयानंदं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम् वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। The sixth gana, Tudadi gana, we are seeing, for which the gana vikarana pratyaya is sha, which is sarvadhatukam, right? Think it's sarvadhatukam, it is sarvadhatukam, and it is apit. Therefore, angakarya is negated, and we saw an important rule. When ajadi pratyaya follows the dhatu ending with ivarna or uvarna, it will be replaced by ya and u. This is an apavada to sandhi. Sandhi sutra is Ikoyanachi is 6177, whereas this is 6477. It has got paratvam. Later, it appears later. Therefore, this is applied. Therefore, you can see the form ri become riyati, etc. All those things we saw. P become piyati. Ivarnanta dhatu, di diyati. Kshi becomes kshiyati. Similarly, uvarnanta dhatu, when followed by ajadi pratyaya, the content of sha being a, therefore ajadi, then it is replaced by u, guvati, gu becomes guvati, dhru becomes dhruvati, ku becomes kuvate, atmani padidatu, nu becomes nuvati, shu becomes suvati, etc. Visa. Then rikaranta dhatu, when followed by sha pratyaya, Ravarna is replaced by Ri. So, Pru will become Priyate, Mru become Priyate, Dru, Driyate, etc. Visa. If it is Rukara Antadatu, Dirga Rukara, then then rkara will get e adesha. This is a rule which doesn't have any nimitta. Ravarnanta dhatu will be replaced by e. Ravarnanta dhatu will be replaced by e. Since ru is replaced by e, which is an unletter, therefore repa will be appended to it, therefore ir. So rukaranta dhatu will be replaced by ir. This is 7100. Now here, if you see kru dhatu, first it rukara is replaced by ir, therefore kir. After that you can add ganavikrana pratyaya, so you will get the form kirati. Similarly guru will become girati, etc. Here the rule is ruvarnanta dhatu replaced by ir. If that is the case, what will happen to tru dhatu belongs to which gana?
First gana
belongs to first gana. So what does it mean? Tru is tarane,
tarati.
So what is the form?
Yeah, tarati. Tru becomes the kru becomes aavundi. The ar the teens tru becomes
tarati.
Yeah, tarati.
So tru plus tip, if you do latlakara, if you replace by this rule, ruvarna replaced by ir, so ti will become, the ru will become
tir.
Tir. What is the ganavikarana?
Shap. That is shap, so it will become a.
So tir tirati. Plus shap plus tip. Then what happens next?
Tirati, it will become.
Not tirati.
But it won't.
Upada is varasvaikara. Therefore,
te.
Guna will happen. Ter plus a become tera. Terati. Terati, terataha, teranti. No, that is not the form. The form is
tarati.
Tarati. So, trudhatu. Tridhatu, here shap ganavikarna follows. Here the ganavikarna is shap, which is sarvadhatuka pit. Therefore, it can cause angakarya. So now there is a competition between the two rules. That is, rivarnanta dhatu replaced by here. This is one rule. This is one rule. The next rule is rivarnanta dhatu, when it is followed by a sarvadhataka pit pratyaya, ru will be replaced by what letter?
R
will be replaced by a guna letter, right?
Yeah.
Ru is replaced by
guna letter R.
When a sarvadhataka rajadhataka pratyaya follows, this igantasya angasya gunaha bhavati, rasva ik upadayaha gunaha bhavati, we know. So here ru is antya varna. It is replaced by a guna letter. It is replaced by a. A being a an letter, repa will be appended to it, ar will come. Now between these two, which one you will apply? This number is 7100. This is 7384. Just giving this. Between these two, which one you will apply? You have to apply 7384, because this is antaranga. This is paratvam. This has got paratvam. So this has to be applied. Not 7100. Not that Ravarna is replaced by the current rule, what we See what you're saying now. That will not apply. If you apply that, then form will become Therati. That is not Ishta. Ishta Rupam. So, therefore, Kim Bhavati Angasya Unakarya. Angakarya Bhavati. Understand?
Yes, Chia.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
There is a Vartikam. I will write a Vartikam as a note here. Maybe in first gana we see this. I'm not sure whether we saw that in first gana, because Tridhatu belongs to first gana. In that context, whether we saw this or not, I'm not sure. That is Ivarna and Uvarna. This itra utvabhyam gunavriddhi vipratishedena. That's a vartika. Itra utvabhyam. Itra utvabhyam. So itra utva is I can join this. Itvot bhyam. That is itva and utva. Abhyam gunavriddhi vipratishedana. This is a vartikam. Vartikam also, since we are doing without the ashtadhyayi, that is sutram, vartikam also you can consider as a rule. So, as a sutram, what I mean is sutram, I'll give the English meaning of that. So there's a vartikam to this rule, that is Ravarna replaced by ir. That rule is there, for that there is a vartikam. This vartikam also can be taken as a rule. So this vartikam says that this guna and vriddhi angakarya, then this wherever that itva adesha is this rule, what is the adesha? Ravarna is replaced by e, that is called itva adesha. Similarly, there is another place where Ravarna is replaced by u. So here this itva part is this rule. Ravarnanta dhatu replaced by e. That is the current, the rule what we saw in the last class. Ravarnanta dhatu will get e adesha. So therefore it's called itva adesha. Itva adesha vidhi. Itva adesha vidhi. If you want, we can write within bracket. This is called itva, itvam, or simply you can call it as itvam. And there is another rule next to this, where it gets utva adesha. That is, rule is not required in this context, just mentioning to know this utva. That is, there is a rule, udoshtya purvasya. That is, ravarnanta dhatu, right here, this is, you can take this as number 1. Then there is number 2. Ravarnanta dhatu. Dhatu ending with R varna, dirgharkara. Ravarnanta dhatu having oshtya letter, oshtya varna. What are oshtya varna?
Papa Bhama.
Papa Bhama. Oshtya varna. Ruvarna antadatu having oshte varna as its upada. Upada is the penultimate. As its upada. Ruvarna antadatu having oshte varna as its upada will get u adesha. You will get u adesha. This is called utva. Utva adesha. Utvam. This is what is said in the Vartika. Itva utvabhyam. I can give an example for this. This not the rule we are seeing, but just for the sake of completion, this rule also you can see. Example, you can take prudhatu. 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 Prupurane. Palana poshana yoga. It is third gana dhatu, prudhatu. You can take this dhatu, prudhatu. Now, pru plus, I'm giving a kridanta example. Pru plus null, what will happen? Pru plus null. Kimbhavati? If you apply 7100, Ruvarna will be replaced by ir. But Ruvarnanta dhatu, it is preceded by oshtya letter pakara. Pakara plus ru. Therefore, it will not get itva adesha, it will get utva adesha. Ruvarnanta dhatu having oshtya letter as its upada will get u adesha, that is utva adesha. Therefore, pru will get that ru will get what adesha? Uradesha, right? Therefore, what is the form? Pru will be
Puraka.
Pru will be Pur.
Pura.
Ru is there. Ru is replaced by U and Repa is appended because Ukara being Anvarna, unlettered. Therefore, when Rukara is replaced by An, Repa is appended, therefore Ur Adesha in the place of Ru Kara, therefore Pur. Pur plus then Null. Then you get Pur. Pur plus
Akka.
Yes, Null. Now Pur plus Null. Pur plus U being what letter? Who being?
Hasvay.
You that before that this nakara is there because of nit. Therefore, what will happen to? Therefore, what will happen to that pur, the pu?
It could not happen pu.
You become poor. Poor plus. Pur will become Pur. Pur plus Akka. So what form you get? What is the final form?
Pur
Akka. But this is not the form.
Yeah.
This is not the form. Here, Pur will get Utva Adesha. Fine. But here nit follows. Therefore, angakarya will happen or not? Angakarya will happen or not?
No.
No, it has to happen. Angakarya is stronger than this. Angakarya is stronger than utva adesha. So, itva adesha for that, this is an example. When there is a competition between Itva Adesha and Angakarya, Angakarya overrules, precedes. Similarly, when there is a competition between Utva Adesha and Angakarya, Angakarya precedes over Utva. Therefore, in this example, Pru plus Null, Pru is supposed to be replaced by Ur, but what will happen? Because Nit Pratyaya follows. Because Nit Pratyaya follows, therefore Angakarya overrules that Uttva Adesha. Angakarya overrules the replacement of Rikara by Ur. Therefore, it is not Pur in this example. If you do it, you will get the form Poraka. That is not Ishtam. So, what will happen now? Puru will be replaced by Puru will be replaced by what letter? What is Angakarya?
Ar.
Ar.
Not Ar.
Ar.
It is Par, not Pur. So Pur is negate. Pur is overruled by the Angakarya because the Pratyaya is Nit Pratyaya. We know when Nit Pratyaya follows, like Nijanta and all, we have seen Nich. So Nit Pratyaya follows Igantasya Vriddhi Bhavati. Therefore, Pru will be, but Ru will be replaced by R. So Par plus Nul. Now Nul is that wu, content of Nul being Wu, and Wu is replaced by Aka. Therefore, you get the form, Paraka, not Poraka. So this is the form Paraka. In fact, this is a counter example. This is a counter example. I'll give another example where it is replaced by Ur. Let me give another example where it is replaced by Ur. Puru plus, what example I'll give? Let me think. Where guna should not happen. Okay. Guna should not happen, therefore I take the Ta Pratyaya as an example. Ta Pratyaya being Kith Pratyaya, therefore Angakaryam Na Bhavati. So this you can take it as Yatireka Udaharanam. And this you can take another Udaharanam, that is Pru plus Ta Pratyaya. Bring kit pratyaya, therefore Angakarya will not happen. When Angakarya doesn't happen, what will happen to Rukara of the Dhatu Pru? By this rule, Ruvarnanta Dhatu having Oshtyavarna as its Upada will get Uttva Adesha, therefore Pru will be replaced by Ur. In this case, it is replaced by Ur, therefore Pur plus Ta Pratyaya. After that, what will happen? Repa is there, followed by a hal, preceded by a ik letter. We have seen the rule. We have seen this rule. That is, repa or vakara, followed by a hal, and preceded by Ikvarna, then what will happen to the Ikvarna? It will get Dirgadesha. Therefore, you will get a form Pur. Pur plus Ta. You get Purta. This is how you get the form Purta. So, in this example, Ruvarna is replaced by Ur, whereas here, Ruvarna is not replaced by Ur because Angakarya presides over Uttva Adesha. So this is the example where it is replaced by Ur, and Vitireka Udharanam where it is not replaced. Angakarya presides over Uttva Adesha. So you understand this example?
Yeah.
I'm not sure whether we saw this rule. That is, here, Repa or Vakara, when followed by Hal and preceded by Ukara, it will get Dirga Adesha.
You have not seen. No, we have not seen.
You have not seen. Okay. Irvoga Upadayaha Dirgaha Ikaha. This is in Tripadi section. Anyway, just to note that. This is because I have to give some give an example. Therefore, I have to use this rule. Irvoga upadayaha dirgaha yukaha. This is the rule. That is, irvoga is repa or bakara. Upadayaha, upada letter. Upada letter, which is ik, ik upada letter, will get dirgadesha when it is followed by takara. When it follows, or not takara, when it is followed by hal. When it is followed by al. This is in fact by the rule, halicha. Alicha is a rule, and this irvoga upadayaha dirgaha ikaha comes as anuvritti. So the whole complete rule is this repa or vakara having ik varna as its upada followed by hal will get dirga adesha. This is what the rule is. This rule is not we are not interested now. This is incidental because I am using ta pratyaya here. I'm using ta pratyaya to show why using ta pratyaya guna doesn't happen. So therefore I took this example here. I took this example ta pratyaya because I want the pratyaya which will not cause angakarya. If it causes angakarya, then utvadesha will not come. So to give an example for utvadesha, I have to take an example where the pratyaya must have either kit or pratyaya must be a kit or nit or git. So I took this example, ta pratyaya here. The content of ta being ta pratyaya, which begins with hal. So when hal follows what? Repa, which is preceded by rasva ik letter. Rasva ik will take dirgadesha. So therefore I have to mention this, I have to apply this niyama, which is not we are interested, but it is an incidental rule. Therefore, you can note it. So this, you understand this, the incidental rule, this much is enough. Halicha is when hal follows. Hal follows what? Irvoho, repa and vakara. When repa and vakara followed by hal, and upada is penultimate. Upada to repa or vakara. If it is ik letter will take dhirga adesha. By applying that, you get the form purta. So in this derivation of the form purta, you see rukara is replaced by ur letter. It's utvadesha. Duvarnaya gets utvadesha. Whereas here in this example, pru plus null, where null being a ardhadhatuka pratyaya, it can cause angakarya. So here, will you apply angakarya or utvadesha? Utvadesha is dismissed or is overruled by angakarya. Therefore, pru will become paraka. This is Gatireka Udharana. So this is an example for utvadesha. So now you understand what is itvadesha. What is utvadesha? Now you come to the vartika, what we are seeing. In this vartikam, which we are interested, let me put it there. Now I take the example of thru. Thru dhatu belonging to first kana, which is Ruvarnanta dhatu should be replaced by ir. It should get itvadesha. If it gets itvadesha, you get terati. That is not ishtarupam. So, ruvarna replaced by ir, which is 7100. And ruvarna getting gunadesha by 7384. That is angakarya. So, among these two, what will apply? For that, there is a vartika which says, itva utva bhyam. So this is the connection. Here itva is there, itva we know. For utva, I explain now what is utva. So where itva adesha and utva adesha. Itva utva bhyam gunavriddhi vipratishedena. So itva utva bhyam gunavriddhi విప్రతిషేధేన గుణవృద్ధి విప్రతిషేధేన ఎస్ వెన్ దర్ ఈస్ అ ఇత్వ ఆదేశ అండ్ ఉత్వ ఆదేశ గుణవృద్ధి విప్రతిషేధేన దట్ ఈస్ గుణ అండ్ వృద్ధి గుణ అండ్ వృద్ధి దట్ విల్ ప్రిసైడ్ దట్ విల్ ప్రిసీడ్ దట్ విల్ ప్రిసీడ్ ఓవర్ దిస్ ఇత్వాదేశ ఉత్వాదేశ సో వెన్ దర్ ఈస్ అ కాంపిటీషన్ బిట్వీన్ ఇత్వాదేశ అండ్ ఇత్వాదేశ బిట్వీన్ ఇత్వాదేశ ఉత్వాదేశ అండ్ గుణవృద్ధి then gunavruddhi will preside. This is what this vartika says. So when itvadesha utvadesha and gunavruddhi, when these two things are simultaneously applicable, then gunavruddhi alone will apply. That is what this vartika says. So itva utva abhyam is panchami vibhakti. So gunavruddhi vipratishedena. So then itva utva adesha can happen. And gunavriddhi also can happen. Gunavriddhi is gunakarya or vriddhikarya can happen. Then gunavriddhi precedes over the itta utvadesha. So the meaning of this vartika is where there is applicability. Applicability of itva adesha or utva adesha, where there is applicability of itva adesha, itva utva adesha, and gunavriddhyanga karya. Gunavruddhi karya, anga karya, where there is applicability of itvadesha, itto utvadesha, and gunavruddhi anga karya, there gunavruddhi anga karya will proceed over itva utva adesha. This is the meaning of this vartika. So therefore, now if you take this example, tru plus ti plus tarati, it will not become terati. So here what will happen? Tru plus tip. So don't apply itvadesha. Because shap being a ganavikarana pratyaya, it can cause angakarya. Therefore, tru will become tar. Gunadesha ha bhavati. Tar plus shap. The content of shap is a. So tar plus a plus. T. Therefore, you get the form tarati. So, therefore, the form of tru is tarati. Whereas the form of gru is kirati. Here, utvadesha bhavati. Because sha being a sarvadhatuka pit, no angakarya. But angakarya is not there. Replace rukara by ir. Rukara by ur. Whatever it is, if it is oshtyavarna precedes, if oshtyavarna precedes, then get utvadesha. So the applicability between the applicability of itva adesha, itva utva adesha, and gunavriddhi angakarya, gunavriddhi angakarya precedes over itva utva adesha. This is by this vartikam. This is a, you can take it as a rule. Okay. If you apply Itto Adesha, you will get this example, Therati, but it is not Ishtam. So you can take it as a negative example. So Therati is not the form. Tarati. Tarati, Shokam, Atmavit. The word Tarati we have seen, the Upanishad. So therefore, Angakarya happens, you get the form Tarati, Tarataha, Taranti, Iti Rupam. Okay, this is some incidental information here. Tridhatu belongs to first gana, not to the adhigana. So there we didn't discuss this because in the first gana this is not required. But in this gana, when we discuss the dhatu, rukaranta dhatu in this gana, we need to know what happens to rukaranta dhatu in the other gana. So first gana where angakarya possibility is there. Then the question comes, which one you will apply? Will you apply Itva Adesha or will you do Angakarya? That question should come. So for that, the answer is by this Vartika, Guna Vriddhi Angakarya overrules Itva Utva Adesha. Is it clear?
Yes, dear. Yeah.
Any doubt?
It's clear, Ji. I'm able to follow.
Now, here, one more thing I will add. It is not connected here, but let me add one more thing. And here, the first one is Itvadesha. Ravarnanta Dhatu, get Itvadesha. The second one I gave, Ravarnanta Dhatu, having Oshtya Upada, Oshtya Varnas Upada will get Utvadesha. That's one more is there. So I will make this as number three, and I'll add one more here. That is number two. Not connected here, not useful here, but later it will be useful in some other context. You can see that. Here, the next one is number two. Number two is Dhatu having Upada, Upada Rikara, that also will get Itvadesha. Dhatu having Upada. So, not Rivarnanta Dhatu. The next one is Dhatu having Rivarna as its Upada. We'll also get E Adesha, that is Ittam. We'll also get Itva Adesha. The first one we said Rivarnanta Antya Varna should be Rukara. If Antya Varna is Rukara, it will get Itva Adesha. Now we say Rivarna, even if it is there in the Dhatu as its Upada, it will get Itva Adesha. It will get Itva Adesha. Example, then take Krut Dhatu. Krut Dhatu. Krut Dhatu, which Gana is that? It must be 10th Gana Dhatu. Let me check. 10th Gana. Yes, Krut. Samshabdane, Churadigana Dhatu. Therefore, you need to add Nich. What will happen when you add Nich to Krut Dhatu? What will happen?
Vriddhi.
Krut plus Nich.
It will not happen.
Vriddhi. Katam Vriddhi. Takara is not the letter, okay? Rukara is the Upada letter.
So we have to do that. So
It isn't shorted. So It is not shorted, right?
Dirga Rukara. Therefore,
Dirga Rukara.
Therefore,
Nothing will Guna will not happen.
Guna will not happen. Very good. Niche is. When ni follows, What did we say? That ik, antya ik will take vriddhi. Then rasva akara will take rasva upada akara will take vriddhi a. And rasva ik upada will take guna. But here upada letter is what? Rukara. How can it undergo guna karya or vriddhi karya? Kameshwariji. Clear? It will not happen.
Yes, sir.
So you have to remember that anga karya, the four or five points I mentioned. If it is iganta dhatu will take what? Guna or vriddhi. Vriddhi will happen when nich or when nit pratyaya, when pratyaya having nakara as it letter. If it is nakara or nya, nikara, nit or nyit. When nit pratyaya or nyit pratyaya follows, rasva, that is the not rasva, that iganta dhatu, ik anta dhatu will take vriddhi, that is number one. And dhatu having rasva akara as its upada, when followed by nitargit, will take dirga adesha, becomes the vriddhi adesha, becomes a, it gets vriddhi adesha. Dhatu having rasva ikupada will take guna adesha. Now here, nit pratyaya follows, and dhatu having dirga ik letter. When dirga ik letter as its upada, then no angakarya happens. Right? Is it clear? You remember this? These are the important rules which we saw long back. That gunadi angakarya. Many places we have seen. That is rasva. Okay, let me write like that. Iganta dhatu. Rasva ik upada dhatu rasva a upada dhatu. Now iganta dhatu when followed by nit or nit pratyaya kimbhavati, vriddhi will happen. Vriddhi angakarya will happen. Rasva ikupada followed by nitar nit. What will happen? Vriddhi. What will happen? Vriddhi or guna?
Guna will happen.
Guna will happen. Rasva a upada dhatu followed by nitar nit. What will happen?
Guna.
Not guna, vriddhi. I will become a, right? Rasva akara, what will happen? It will take?
Yeah.
Vriddhi adesh. Since we are dealing with here nich, therefore I am giving example of nich. If it is not nit or nit, then what will happen? If it is a not a nitta or nit, but it is a sarvadhatuka radhadhatuka pratyaya having not nitta or nit, but it can cause angakarya. Then what will happen?
Instead of vriddhi, the guna will happen for ik letter.
Just writing sarvadhatuka radhadhatuka pratyaya follows. Iganta will take guna or vriddhi?
It will be guna.
Guna will happen. If it is rasva ikupada followed by sarvadhatuka or adhadhatuka pratyaya, then kimbhavati?
Then also guna.
Guna.
Then also guna only.
If it is rasva akara, that doesn't, nothing happen here.
Nothing will happen here.
These are the five rules which we saw many times before. Remember this important angakarya related niyama. This you remember or not?
Yes,
yeah.
Yes, recall this. This is important. This is very, very important. We apply this. When we deal with Iganta, we apply this. And Kridanta, of course, it's applied. So, Iganta Dhatu followed by the pratyaya having nakara or nyakara as ith letter will take vriddhi adesha. Rasva ikupada will take guna adesha. Rasva avarna will take vriddhi adesha. This is with regard to the nit or nit pratyaya. Then we have, when sarvadhatuka adhatuka pratyaya follows, iganta will take guna, rasvaikupada will take guna. So now krut plus nich being a nit pratyaya follows, what angakarya will happen, I ask. Any possibility is here. This you cannot apply. So because here the pratyaya is nit pratyaya, it is not rasva upada, that will not apply. It is not iganta, ikanta, therefore that also will not apply. Rasvaik upada will take gunadesha. It is rasvaik, no. So that also will not apply. Then what will apply? No angakarya happens. Understand? Kameshwar, is it clear? No angakarya happens.
Yes.
So that no angakarya happens. Now Ruvarna as its upada will get what adesha? I adesha, itva adesha. So replace it by ir. Replace by I, repa is appended, therefore kirt plus nich. Kirt plus nich. Right? Up to this, you understand?
Yes, Jaya.
Yes, sure.
Then after that, what will happen? Can we do angakarya now? K will become K?
No.
Why?
Upada is repa. No?
Upada is repa. Upada is not E. K plus repa plus takara. So, therefore, kirt plus E. Now what will happen? Repa followed by what letter?
Takara.
Repa followed by what letter? Here. Followed by? Takara, right?
Takara.
Preceded by?
Preceded by an letter.
Preceded by what letter?
E.
Equal.
Therefore, what will apply? Can we not apply this?
Okay.
Repa followed by hal. Preceded by.
Dirga ikka.
Kimbavati.
Dirga.
Dirga
happens.
Dirga will happen, right?
Yeah.
So, therefore, it will become kirt plus e. So, what do you get now? Kirti. Now, kirti is what? New dhatu. Kirti is a new dhatu. Now you can derive the latlakara of kirti dhatu. Kirti plus tip. Kimbavati. Now you tell me. It is simple. You can do it. Tell the sequence. I'll type.
Kirtayati.
Yes.
Kirtayati.
So what will happen? Kirti plus shap will come, right? Then after that, Shap is the Gana Vikrana because this treated to be Dhatu as though belonging to Bhavadi Gana, Shap will come. So what will happen to Kirti now?
Kirti.
Because it is Igantha, therefore it become Guna Kirte plus A plus T. A plus T. Kirte. Then after that, Ayadi
Sandhi will
Kirtai. Kirtai. Kirtayati. This is the form. Kirtayati. So this is an example for Ruvarna, which is Upada getting Itvadesha. So you can note this. So Krut will, the Krut will become Kirti. A new Dhatu is derived by adding Nich Pratyaya. Now here Dirgatvam happens by this rule. Please remember the 72, that is 77 Halicha.
82.
Sorry, 82. It is Tripari section, yeah. it do not down to, yes. It is in Tripadi. Then after that, Kirti plus Tip. If you do, then Shap will come, then you get the form Kirtayati. So the summary is, Rivarnanta Dhatu will get Itvadesha. Dhatu having Rivarna as its Upada will get Itvadesha. Rivarnanta Dhatu having Oshtyavarna as its Upada will get Utvadesha. The Oshtyavarna as Upada and Rivarnanta Dhatu having Oshtyavarna as Upada will get Utvadesha. This is Apavada to number 2. So this is by the rule 71101, and Rivarna as Oshtyavarna is 71103, I think. 71102, sorry, next one. 71102 is exception, Apavada to 71101. So Udoshtya Purvasya. So these three rules, the three rules where you see the Itta Utta Adesha ordained for Rukara. Rukara. Where Rukara is located, that you have to see. If it is at the end or Upada. If it is Upada and Upada, then it get Itta Adesha. So Upada. Rivarna as Upada will get Itvadesha. Rivarnanta Dhatu will get Itvadesha. Then Rivarnanta Dhatu having Oshtyavarna. Oh, sorry. This is 71102 is not Apavada to this one. 71102 is Apavada to 100. 71102, which ordains Utvadesha, is Apavada to 71100. Okay, not 71101, because 71101 where Rivarna is Upada, Upada of the Dhatu. 71102 is Apavada to 71100. Let me write the rule here. Here it is. Upadayascha. Upadayascha. Rutaha iddhatoho 71100. This is Upada Yascha. Then Udoshtya Purvasya. That is 71. Udoshtya Purvasya 71102. So Udoshtya Purvasya is Apavada to Rutaha iddhatoho, which is 71100. So you can call this as Adesha ordained for Rukara. So you can remember this set of rules where Adesha is ordained for Rukara, Rivarna. So the three roots. Rutaha iddhatoho upadayascha udoshtya purvasya. Okay. So here the itvadesha, the first two is itvadesha, the last one is putvadesha. This is what is mentioned in this vartikam. So I'll write here. Residence of Gunavruddhi Angakarya over Itva Utva Adesha. For that, first we took three as an example. Therati we get, that is not the Ishtarupam. So by this, Vartika, which states, when there is an applicability of Itva Utva Adesha, and guna adhyanga karya, guna adhyanga karya will preside. Therefore, you get the form tarati. All these are incidental information. In the process, we learned the other rules also. Another some more incidental rules, like when Repa followed by Hal, preceded by Ikvarna, that Ikvarna will take Dirgadesha. This also you can note. Maybe I can give the meaning of this in English. I put star mark here and tell you the meaning here. When Repa or Vakara, when Repa or Vakara is followed by Hal, Repa Vakara, Repa or Vakara followed by Hal, preceded by Ik. Repa or Vakara followed by Hal, Hal preceded by Ik. Ik will get Dirgadesha. Ik will get Dirgadesha. I'll write like this: when followed by, when followed by Repa or Vakara, which in turn is followed by, I'm rewriting this, which in turn followed by Al. I think this will make sense. Ik will get Dirgadesha when followed by Repa or Vakara, which in turn is followed by Hal. Is it clear this?
Yes, dear.
I put a star mark here. So for this meaning of this rule, Halicha. Okay. So therefore, you get Dirgadesha, and this is incidental. A purta, for that purta, this exam, for this example, since we are applying this rule, therefore you need to know that. Fine. Continuing, then Vartika Visa. Then special dhatus. Under special dhatus, we saw the replacement of shadalu by shiya and sida, that we saw in the last class. Then ishu gami yamam chaha, ishu ichayam, dhatu will get the adesha, will get the, that shakara, not the whole dhatu, the shakara gets the chakara adesha. Then Tukkagama comes, then we get the form Ichati. This dhatu is Ishu dhatu. Ishu Ichayam. That is, the dhatu belonging to the Tudadigana only. The content of Ishu is Ish. And there are many dhatus, two or three dhatus, the dhatu pata having the content Ish. But this Adesha, that is Chakara Adesha, ordained for Shakara, is only for Ishu dhatu, which belongs to Tudadigana. And therefore, you get the form Ichati. Then Trutta Dhatu, we saw Trutta Dhatu will get optionally Shen. Therefore, you will have two forms, that is Truttati or Trutyati. Then Masjid Dhatu, simple one. There Shutva Sandhi and Jashva Sandhi number two applied. We got the form Majjati. Similarly, Lest become Lajjati. Then Vich Dhatu, Tudadigana will get Aya Pratyaya, and therefore it becomes a new dhatu. Once you get a new dhatu, then you add Shap. So we get the form Vichayati. The form is Vichayati. Then comes the next is dhatu Samprasaranya Dhatu. Samprasarani Dhatavaha. That we will see. This is the topic we are going to see today. So up to this, we have done in the last class. Now, Samprasarani Dhatavaha. So this we will do today. I hope it's clear up to here, right?
Yes, dear.
So when we do, incidental rules will come. That please note that it may be useful in some other places. Okay, now Samprasaranam. What is Samprasaranam?
Reversal of
Yen Sandhi. Yen Sandhi is Samprasaranam. Fine. Now, when does it apply? Samprasaranam applies. When does it apply? We have seen this also, the application of the Samprasaranam. When did we apply?
When followed by Krit Pratyaya.
When followed by?
Krit.
What Pratyaya?
Lyap. Lyap.
Yes, when followed by Kit or Git Pratyaya for some certain dhatus. When followed by Kit Pratyaya or Git Pratyaya, we did the Samprasaranam. I think we have done for some dhatus in the first gana and other gana. For first gana and other gana, we have done this Samprasaranam. For example, what dhatu?
Swap becomes supta, ta pratyaya,
etc. Yes. So in this gana itself, there are some dhatus which will take some prasaranam. Okay, let me give you the list. You have to recollect what we saw before. Let me give you the list of dhatus which can undergo some prasaranam. Then we will see the dhatus which belong to Tadadigana taking Samprasaranam. I will mention the sutram where Samprasaranam is ordained for the dhatus. Vachiswapi Ejadinam Kiti. Vachiswapi Ejadinam Kiti. When Kit Pratyaya follows, Vachidatu, Swapdatu, and Dhatu belonging to the subgroup Yajadinam, that is Yaj is a subgroup with Antargana, which will get Samprasaranam, will undergo Samprasaranam. Vachiswapi Yajadinam. So it is Yaj means it Pujane, Deva Puja, Yajane, that Yajadatu. Vachiswapi Yajadinam. So these Vachis is one dhatu and Swap is another dhatu. Then this Yajadi, under Yajadi, Yajadi is a subgana, antargana. There are some dhatus under Yajadi. So those dhatus will get Samprasaranam when a Kit Pratyaya follows. When a Kit Pratyaya follows, Samprasaranam will happen. This is one place. This is one place where Samprasaranam happens. Vachiswapi Ejadinam Kiti. Then the next set of dhatus where Samprasaranam can happen is Grahi Jya Vai Vyadhi Vashti Vichati Vrishchati Prichati Brijjatina Niticha, the immediate following rule. So, combining this two, when Vach Dhatu, Swap Dhatu, and Yajadinam, the Dhatus which are there in the Yajadi, Antargana, Yajadi, Yajadhatu, which is in which gana, it is in first gana. First gana, there is an Bhavadigana, there is an Antargana. Antargana means the subgroup which begins with Yaj. So a group of dhatus are there under Ejadi. Ejadi means Dhatu beginning with yaj, which is an antargana subgroup in the bhuadigana. So those dhatus, those set of dhatus, and vach dhatu, swab dhatu, when kit pratyaya follows, very specifically, kit pratyaya follows, what will happen? Samprasaranam happens. Then the next rule, sutram says, grahi, grak dhatu, jya dhatu, vayi dhatu, vedi, vedi is another one dhatu, vashti, vichati, vrish dhatu, then prach dhatu, becomes prachati, then brijati nam, this set of dhatus, dhatus which are mentioned here. How many dhatus? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 dhatus are there. When followed by niti, it pratyaya, and chakarat, kit also. So when followed by kit or nit pratyaya, will undergo samprasaranam. So these 9 dhatus, when followed by kit or nit pratyaya, will undergo samprasaranam. Whereas here, vach dhatu, swab dhatu, and dhatu under ejadigana, when followed by kit pratyaya only, will undergo samprasaranam. This is what. This is where the samprasaranam happens under this condition. So if you put it in writing, let me put it in writing. Vach dhatu, swap dhatu, and dhatus belonging to the antargana. Antargana means subgroup. Antargana Ejadi of Bhuadigana will undergo Samprasaranam when followed by Kit Pratyaya. When followed by Kit Pratyaya. Then the Dhatus let me give you the set of dhatus, just a minute. Dhatus, grak dhatu, then jya dhatu, then venj dhatu, in fact it is venj dhatu, Venj dhatu, it becomes vayi, vayi vyashti, then vyad dhatu, then becomes vash dhatu, then vash dhatu, then vyach dhatu, and vrasht dhatu, vraschu, vrasht dhatu, then trach dhatu, then brush dhatu, these dhatus and brush dhatu, this and brush dhatu, dhatus grak jya venj vyad vash vyach vrascha pracha and brush will get samprasaranam. Samprasaranam is samprasarana adesha. Samprasaranam will come in the place of samprasaranam is n, the reversal of n, right? Ik letter replaced by n is n sandhi. N letter replaced by ik letter is samprasaranam. So in the dhatu where the n letters are there, it is replaced by ik letter. So samprasaranam adesha means ik adesha will come in the place of n. So we'll get n adesha, samprasaranam adesha. We'll get ikadesha, not so. We'll get ikadesha, that is samprasarana adesha, when followed by kit or nit pratyaya. Note, these are the dhatus for which the condition is kit or nit, whereas the first three dhatus, for which only kit pratyaya. So this is, these are the samprasarana dhatavaha. So let me write in detail. You can just check the dhatu kosha also. This vach dhatu, it is vachi. Vach dhatu, it is vachi. It is paribhashane. Meaning is paribhashane. Which gana is that? Let me check 1 minute. Vachi paribhashane. It is not vachi, vacha. Vacha paribhashane. It is in adhadigana as well as in churadigana. So vacha paribhashane. Then swap. Swabdhatu, swabdhatu, which meaning shaye, aupadeshika, I will write the aupadeshika dhatu, within bracket I will write the this form. Aupadeshika dhatu is vacha, and here it is nish, vap. After the anubandha panayana, removing the anubandha, you get the form swap, meaning is shaye. Then ejadi antargana. Ejadi antargana, I will show you those dhatus for which you have to take the dhatu patha. Dhatu patha, I will show you that is in vadigana, ejadi antargana. Just a minute, I will open that. Okay, 7:36. You have this Dhatupata with you.
Yes, you
before 7:36, you can see. Atha, do you see the screen? Atha yaja dayaha.
Yeah, yeah.
Yaja deva puja sangati karnadhaneshu. That yaja dayaha, the star is there. That is, yaja daya is a subgroup, antargana of which gana? You can see, bhavadigana. It is bhavadigana dhatu. You can see, bhavadiganaha. It's written here. So first gana we have the subgroup atha yajadayaha. So 7:36 yaja, 7:37 duvap, then vaha prapane bajadayaha. Okay, then vasa nivase, that is yajadi dhatu. Venj, vyenj, khvenj, all these are yajadi. Vada, then tuoshvi. Yajadayaha bhuadayascha vrittaha. Vrittaha means antaha ityartaha. So, starting from 7:36 up to 7:49. What are dhatus are there? You take. How many dhatus are there? You can count. First is yaja. Second one is duvap. That is vap dhatu. Vap is to sow. Bija santane. 7:37. Then 7:38. Vaha prapane. 7:39 is not a dhatu. Just tell you, that gives you the swara. So 7:39 you can neglect. Then vasa nivase, number 4. Anudata udatyate, this swara, not required. Then venj dhatu, number 5. Venj dhatu, number 6. Venj dhatu, number 7. Then the next sutra, next one is a swara, that is not required. 7:46, vada. And 7:47, two shvi, so 9 dhatus. The next one is vadati shvayati udato, that is not required. And 7:49 also not required. So 9 dhatus under yajadigana. 9 dhatus under yajadigana. So this will undergo samprasanam. Star mark is there. You can see star mark is explaining here. Ejadi gana nirdeshasya palamtu tatra vachisvapi ejadi nam kiti iti sutranusarena ejadi nam datu nam samprasaranam bhavati kiti prateye pare. This is what we are discussing. You understand? You follow?
Yes, dear.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Parvati ji, Rama ji, clear?
Yes.
So let me write Ejadi Dhatavaha. I'm not writing all the Dhatus. If you want, we can write. Maybe later I will do. 9 Dhatus are there. Ejadi Dhatus. So these 9 plus 2 Dhatus, when followed by Kit Pratyaya, will undergo Samprasaranam. So Samprasaranam for the following, I will say 11 Dhatus, because we counted just now 9 plus 2, 11 Dhatus, when followed by Kit. Kit Pratyaya. Sampradhana Bhavati. Here Vach Dhatu is there. You can see Vach. The content is Vach. Vakara is N. That will undergo Samprasarana. What you will get? Vakara will be replaced by?
Uchyate.
Therefore, Uchyate you get. When you do Karmani form of Vach, what do you get? What the form? Vach plus yak plus te.
Uchyate.
Kit Pratyaya follows. Therefore, Vach, what will happen to Vach? Vakara is replaced by Vakara and followed by what letter? A is there. Don't forget A. Vakara is replaced by Ukara. What will happen to Akara then here? Yeah, the Sandhi chart you see, Samprasaranat cha sutra is that. Right? So this is Ukara, sorry. Ukara is replaced by Ukara. So U plus A, again, don't do N Sandhi. If you do N Sandhi, what will happen? Again, you will get Vakara. It's a loop. You will get into a loop. So U is what? U is the Adesha. It has got a name. What name it has got?
Samprasaranam.
When Samprasaranam is followed by H, then what will happen? Purva and Para will be replaced by Purva, which is
Purva.
Samprasaranam. Therefore, which is U. Therefore, Uch plus Yak plus Te, you get Uchyate. Form is Uchyate. This is an example where you can see Samprasaranam happening for the status when Kit Pratyaya follows. Similarly, the Samprasaranam for the other Dhatus, Samprasaranam for these Dhatus. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 Dhatus are there. Samprasaranam for the following 9 Dhatus when followed by Kit or Nit. Here the condition is also for Nit. Kit as well as Nit. So let me write those Dhatus. Among these Dhatus, what Dhatus we are interested? We are interested only in Tudadi Gana Dhatu. That we have to separate it out. Now let us see all the Dhatus and then we will separate out. Graha. Which gana is the 9th gana? Upadane. I'm just writing the meaning. Then similarly, jya. Vayohano. Jya vayohano. Then. Venj dot. That becomes vayi. Venjaha vayi. That we will see later how it becomes vai when adhatuka pratyaya follows venj dhatu. तंतु संतानी भवादिगण देन नेक्स्ट धातु व्यद ताड़ने देन वश कांतौ देन व्यच धातु व्याजीकरणे देन ओ व्रश्चु ओ व्रश्चु इज धातु औपदेशिक धातु द कंटेंट इज व्रश्च ओ इज इतलेटर देन ओ इज आल्सो इतलेटर सो ओ व्रश्चु द कंटेंट इज व्रश्च धातु छेदने फ्रॉम दिस ओनली द वर्ड वृक्ष कम्स व्रश्च सो it is that which can be fill is called vrikshaha and prach dhatu nipsayam prach dhatu then prach dhatu pake so these are the nine dhatus so the dhatus are listed so samprasarana dhatu these are the samprasarana dhatu so it's a big topic all the dhatus are there samprasarana dhatu this knowledge this information knowledge will be useful in other places also so the two sutra the following two sutras list down the dhatus for which samprasarana can happen under the conditions given below the following two sutras mention the dhatus for which samprasaranam will happen under the following condition. These are the two rules. Vachisvapi ajadi nam kiti and grahi jya vayi vyaddi vishti vichati vrishchati prichati vrajati nam iti cha. Okay. Now among these dhatus, we have to take which dhatus belong to tudadigana. For tudadigana, vrash dhatu and prach dhatu, vyach dhatu, brash dhatu. These are the dhatus. These are the dhatus only belonging to the tudadigana. So, tudadigana, gana, dhatu. Tudadigana, samprasarana, dhatu. So, we have to take out the samprasarana dhatus from this tudadigana. What are they? Then we will derive the form. Vrashya dhatu is tudadigana. You can check the dhatu kosha. Vrashya dhatu. O vrashya chedane. Tudadigana dhatu. Parasmipadi dhatu. Vrashya dhatu. Vrashya dhatu. What will be the thing? The latlakara rupam. Vrashya dhatu. Vrashya plus tip. Then what will happen next? What will be the form of rashti dhatu? Latlakara rupam of rashti dhatu. We'll get what vikarana? Sha will come, right?
Yeah.
Rashti plus sha plus tip. So you then here what pratyaya follows?
Sarvadhataka
pratyaya follows, which is shakara. Then what will happen? Samprasaranam will happen or not?
Yeah.
Why does it happen?
Hey.
It is sarvadhatuka apit.
Apitya, apitya.
Therefore, kitvat bhavati.
Mm, okay.
It's not therefore, directly, it yeah. But it gets kittum indirectly.
Yeah, it's apitya.
All of you follow this or not? I'm not sure because.
Yes,
sir.
Sarvadhatuka apit. That which is apit, sarvadhatuka apit. It's very specific. Sarvadhatukam, not adhadhatukam. Sarvadhatuka apit will be deemed to be kit. Will deem to be kit, will deem to be nit. Okay, not kit. Deem to be nit. In the beginning, I said kit because that time we don't know what is nit. That's why I said kit, kit. But it is nit. According to the sutra, it is nit. Okay. Sarvadhatukam apit will be deemed to be nit. I used kit. Please note, I used kit in the beginning. In the very beginning, I used kit. Sarvadhatukam apit kitvat bhavati. Because that time we don't know what is nit. But now you know what is kit, nit, etc. Therefore, I can say sarvadhatukam apit will be deemed to be nit. So, therefore, here sha being a sarvadhatuka pratyaya, and therefore it is apit. Being apit, therefore it is nitvat bhavati. Therefore, vrashadhatu, which is listed here, kutrasti, here it is listed here, vrashchedane, when followed by kittar nit pratyaya, kim bhavati samprasaranam bhavati. So, therefore, Vrasjata will become, what will happen to Vra? Where is N letter? Reversal of N is Samprasaranam. So, N letter must be replaced by Ik letter. So, Vakara is there, then Repa is there, that is a N letter, then followed by Akara, then Sha plus Tip. So, Repa, which is a N letter, will be replaced by what letter?
U.
Huh?
U. R.
Repa.
Sorry.
Samprasaranam.
Rukara.
Repa is replaced by reversal of N. Okay. What is this R? What is its name?
Samprasaranam,
good. So, Samprasaranam followed by H. What will happen? Purvaparyavasthani kim bhavati?
Purvarupam.
That is, Samprasaranam will be the Adesha. R will be the Adesha. So, R plus A plus T. Therefore, you get the form. R. Shakara is a, sorry, I forgot to here. Shakara. Vrashchit, the dhatu is Vrashchit. Then you get the form Vrash. Vakara plus R becomes Vru. Vrish. Vrish plus A plus T will become the form Vrishchati. Okay, I forgot to write Shakara, Chakara, both are the, sorry. I should write again. Dhatu is Shakara, Chakara, Vrashcha Dhatu. So the form is Vrishchati, you can see. Vrashchidhatu will undergo samprasaranam. So here Vrashchidhatu, where Pakara, Repa is there, followed by Akara, then after that Shakara, Chakara, that is a dhatu, Vrashchidhatu, part of the dhatu, the all the consonants here. So Repa is the samprasa, is the N letter, which will undergo samprasaranam, which will be replaced by Ruvarna. Ruvarna get the sanya samprasaranam. So varna followed by a purva paryavastani purva adesha bhavati, that is samprasarana adesha bhavati. Therefore vakara, then ru, then shakara, chakara, content of sha is a, then tip. So therefore, finally you get the form vrischati. So vrischati, vrischataha, vrischanti. So vrasch becomes vrischati. Latlakara rupam is vrischati. So vrashdhatu, vandhatu, vansamprasarana dhatu, which is into dadigana. Similarly, the next one we will take, next dhatu in the in this gana, which is it clear? This understand vrashdhatu rupam?
Yes, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Number
yes.
Two. Number two, next dhatu we can take vyach dhatu. Vyach also it is in this tudadigana. Vyach. Vyach dhatu, which is in this gana, tudadigana, vyajikarane. Vyajikarane means to cheat, to deceive. Vyajikarane, vyach dhatu. So vyaj plus tip, vyach plus tip, vyajikarane, what will happen here? For our understanding, I'm splitting vakara, then comes yakara, then chakara. Then ganavikarana sha plus tip, tip is t. Then what will happen after that?
Now
vakara, yakara, both are what letter?
Both, but
yakara
only undergo
suppressor. Not vakara. You have to go in this
right to left.
Left to right only. Don't start with right to left, huh? Left to right. So yakara as well as vakara both are n letter, but yakara is the one which will undergo samprasaranam. So why? Because followed by the pratyaya sha, which is sarvadatakam apit, therefore nitvat bhavati, therefore nit pratyaya follows. Therefore, vyach dhatu, that yakara will undergo samprasaranam. Yakara will be replaced by what?
Ikara.
Therefore, the rupam would be
vichati.
So vyach dhatu rupam would be vichati, vichataha, vichanti, vichasi, vichataha, vichata. Please note this, yakara is the one which will undergo samprasaranam, will be replaced by ikara. Then ikara is samprasaranam, and samprasaranam follows samprasaranam na bhavati. Vakara, which is also a n letter, which has got the eligibility to undergo samprasaranam, because samprasaranam follows, samprasaranam na bhavati vakarasya. Understand?
Yeah.
Na samprasarane, samprasaranam, apavada, which we have seen in Sandhi chart, it is there. So, remember that.
Have given separately samprasarana sutrani, one file, Sharanji, you said.
Given, right? Yes. Please refer to that. Na samprasarane, samprasaranam. When samprasaranam follows, samprasaranam na bhavati. Okay. The next one. Next dhatu is prachidhatu. This dhatu we know very well. Prachidhatu. Dhatu is prach, not prach. What will happen here? Prachidhatu. This also you can split. Pakara, then repa, then akara, then chakara, chakara. I'm just splitting. Pakara, repa, akara, then cha, then ganavikarana sha comes, which is sarvadatakam apit, therefore nyitvat bhavati, therefore nyit pratyaya follows prachidhatu. Prachidhatu, which has got the n letter, will undergo samprasaranam, therefore replace repa by
ru.
Replacing repa by ru, you get pruchati. After replacing repa by rikara, then purva pariyogostane, that is para letter is h, replace it by ru. Therefore, you get pruchati. Pruchati, pruchataha, pruchanti, pruchasi, pruchataha, pruchata iti. This is third dhatu. Fourth dhatu, which is the last one. Four, only four dhatus are there. The fourth dhatu is the last class, I think Kameshwar, you told this one. Drasya dhatu, which is also a samprasarana, samprasarani dhatu, drasya dhatu. What will happen here for drasya dhatu, which is bakara, then repa, then akara, then sakara, then jakara, followed by sarvadhataka apit pratyasha. So will undergo samprasaranam. Repa will be replaced by r. Repa will be replaced by r. Then then Purva Paryavastani Rikara Adesha Bhavati. Then you will get the form. Akara plus R becomes Br. Brisht plus A plus T. Then Sakara Jakara. What will happen here? Sakara Jakara. Chitta Sandhi will happen. Sakara will be replaced by Shakara.
Shakara.
Brash plus A plus T. Then after that?
Jashvasandhi.
Jashvasandhi. Shakara will be replaced by?
Chakara.
Chakara. Therefore, Bridge plus A plus T. You get the form Bridjati. The rupam is Brijyati. So these are the four dhatus. Brasch, Vyasch, Prach and Brasch dhatu. All the four dhatus are mentioned in the second sutra. Let's go and see here. Here you can Brasch dhatu, Prach dhatu, then Brijyati naam. And where is Vyach? This is Vichati. Vichati is Vyach Dhatu. Here Vichati, he himself, Pani Magarishi himself has given Vichati. But this is Dhatu Adesha anyway. That we will see in the Ashtadhyayi class. Already we have seen in Ashtadhyayi class, Vichati. So these are the four Dhatus. So in this Sutram 6116, the last four Dhatus, they belong to Tudadikana. You can mark it. These four dhatus. This grahi dhatu and all belongs to ninth gana. It belongs to other ganas. Okay. Let us not worry about that. I think we have seen some dhatus in the Bhavadi gana also. Similarly, Vachiswapya Jadinam also. So this, here the 11 dhatus are which are not, which among them, 9 dhatus belong to Bhavadi gana. So we would have seen in Bhavadi gana. We have referred Bhavadi gana section. There we would have mentioned the same thing there, Ajadi. Bhavadigana also, under Samprasaranam, we have seen these dhatus. Ajadigana dhatavaha. Please refer that. So here, the four dhatus, these four dhatus, Yach dhatu, Vrash dhatu, Prach dhatu, and Brash dhatu, when followed by Ngit Parthaya, here it is Ganavikana being Shakara, Ganavikana being Sha, not Shakara, Ganavikana being Sha, which is Sarvadhataka Mapit Ngitvat Bhavati. Therefore, Samprasaranam Bhavati for these four dhatus. So with this Samprasarani, dhatus are also over. Okay, the next one. Any doubt in this?
No, ji.
Here what you need to remember is, when Ngit Pratyaya, when we say, for Tudadigana, Sha is a Ganavikrana, which is Sarvadhatukam Apit. Because it is Apit, therefore it is deemed to be Ngit, therefore Ngit Pratyaya follows. Ngit Pratyaya follows, these dhatus will undergo Samprasaranam. So that connection you need to understand why it is nyit. Sarvadhatakamapit nyit. Therefore, nyit pratyaya follows. Therefore, samprasanam happens for these four dhatus. Then, after this samprasarana, samprasarani dhatavaha, the next one is num agama dhatavaha. The next topic is num agama dhatavaha under this section. There are num agama dhatus. Remember any dhatus, num agama dhatu? We have seen this. Munchati, right?
Yeah.
Munchati, lumpati. There is a there are eight dhatus are there. I just copy paste 1 minute.
She muchadi.
Yes. These are the dhatus. Muchulu, luplu, vidlu, lipha, which is upadehe. Shicha, Kriti, Kida, Parighate, then Pisha. These eight dhatus are num agama dhatus. These eight dhatus are given in the form of a shloka. They are given in the form of a karika. I just copy pasted here. Munchati lumpatis chaiva bindadir limpatis tatha. Sinchati khrinchatis chaiva kidif pishir muchadayaha. So muchadayaha, that muchadi gana. Muchadi gana, which a list which has got this eight dhatus. This eight dhatus belonging to the tudadi gana. And muchadi gana is a subgroup. What will happen? It will take numbagama. So let me write. So let me explain Mujadigana and then I will write. Let us see the Dhatu Pata here. The Dhatu Pata, Tudhadigana, we have to see. Yogotyadigana, then Tudhadigana. It must be Tudhadi. Yes. Tudhadigana. Sixth gana, you will see a subgroup, Uchadi Antargana. Where is Uchadi? Yes. Atta Muchadayaha, you can see here. Atta Muchadayaha, Muchulu, Mokshane, Luplu, Chedane, Vidlu, Labe, Lipa, Upadehe, Shicha, Ksharane. These are the Muchadigana Dhatu. Muchadayaha, Anudataha. Svaritetaha, Muchadigana, it is ending in 154. You have to see the next one. Kriti Chedane, that is also Muchadi. Here, these are the five Muchadi Dhatu, 142, 143, 144, 145, 146. These are the Muchadi Dhatu having the Swara, Anudata, Svarita. Then Muchadigana doesn't stop here. If it stops here, you will use the word Vrittaha. But you see the word Vrittaha. Vritta means Antaha. So Muchadigana stops at 154. So Muchulu, Luplu, Vidlu, Lipa, Shicha, five dhatus. Then Kriti, sixth dhatu. Uswara is given Udata, Udatet, 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 Udata, It, Udatet, Udata, Udatet. Then Kida, 150, the next one, which is Anudata, Udatet. Then Pisha Avayavi Udata Udatet Muchadayaha Tudadayascha Vrittaha. Muchadi and Tudadi Vrittaha means ends. So those dhatus only I have listed. These are the Muchadi Antargana Dhatavaha. So therefore, She Muchadi Nam, by that sutra, when She means what? when followed by shakara. Here tudadigana gana vikrana pratyaya is she dhatu is the pratyaya is the what must follow pratyaya must follow and the pratyaya is she pratyaya when shakara when she is when she pratyaya follows when she pratyaye pare kim bhavati uchadinam uchadinam she uchadinam she pratyaye pare numagama bhavati numagama bhavati. Therefore these eight dhatus which are under tudadigana will get numagama. So uchadi gana is an antargana. Antargana is subgroup. Antargana of tudadigana. There are how many dhatus? Eight dhatus. There are eight dhatus in this gana, in this antargana. Which are listed below. So these are the dhatus. These dhatus are only given in the form of a ekarika, munchati lumpatis chaiva, vindate limpatis tata. So now let us take a few dhatus from this and then derive the form. Simple, this is derivation. So let us take much dhatu. Much dhatu plus tip. Latlakara I am doing. Much plus sha plus tip. So what follows is she. That is shakara. Follows. Shakara is ith letter. Shit pratyaya follows. So this is very important. You have to note. This is specifically only for this gana only. Sha is idi gana vikrana pratyaya of tudadigana. So when sha follows, when sha follows means when the gana vikrana sha follows. When gana vikrana sha follows, which gana will take gana vikrana sha? Only tudadigana. So when gana vikrana sha follows, much dhatu, muchadigana dhatu will get numagama. Where the numagama will come? Num being a mittagama, where it will come?
After the last vowel.
Last vowel. What is the last vowel here? Mu.
Ukara.
Therefore, numagama comes after the ukara. So, munch plus content of sha is a plus ti. Then what will happen? Nakara, chakara will together, nakarasya, shtuta sandhi bhavati, nakara will be replaced by nakara, you get then munchati, munchati, munchataha, munchanti. Generally, lup will get lumpati, vid will get vindati, lipa will get the form limpati, it get numagama, then because followed by pakara, therefore, what will happen? Limpati. How we get limpati? Get numagama, nakara, pakara. What sandhi is that?
Arasavarna.
Arasavarna. Therefore, limpati. Limpati, limpataha, limpanti. Similarly, here, shicha. What is shicha? Dhatu is? Upadeshika dhatu is shicha.
Sinchati.
Yes.
Sinch.
Becomes sich.
Sich.
And if you get numagama, sinch. Then nakara replaced by nakara, sinchati. Sinchati, sinchataha. Then kriti will become kriti to cut. Kartari, that scissor comes from this dhatu, kriti. Will get numagama. So
krintati.
Krintati.
Kid will become Kindati. Then Pisha. Dhatu is Pish. It will get
Pinshati. Pinch.
Pin. Pinch. After that, what will happen?
Anuswara it will become.
Katam Bhavati Anuswaraha Nascha Apadantasya Jali.
Jali.
When Apadanta Nakara followed by Jal, please check the chart.
Yeah, yes.
Nakara Sikim Bhavati Anuswara Bhavati.
Anuswara.
After that, what will happen? Anuswara followed by?
Will it drop?
Hmm?
Anuswara will drop, is it?
Oh, why should Anuswara drop?
Anuswara will not drop, yeah.
Why should Anuswara drop?
No. Okay.
Will Anuswara take Parasvarana? Anuswara no. Followed by Yei only will take Parasvarana.
Yeah, it is Shakara, yet won't take.
Therefore, remain as it is.
As it is. Yeah.
Pimshati, Pimshataha, Pimshanti, Pimshasi, Pimshataha. I'm not writing the form you want me to write. I will write. Is it okay? You cannot. If you want me to write the form for each dhatu, I will write.
We will do it.
So one dhatu, much dhatu I have done, other dhatus are same.
Yeah.
It will get no makama. Maybe pish dhatu I will write. Other dhatu you can write, you can do as homework. Because pish dhatu, you may think avoid that doesn't get parasavana, etc. That pish dhatu will get numakama, pinch, then apadanta nakara followed by jal, it will become anuswara, pinch. This is not a yei letter, therefore anuswara will not be replaced by parasavana, therefore the form is pimshati only. Pimshati, pimshataha, pimshanti. So this is for the muchadi antargana, where these eight dhatus, when followed by sha, when followed by the pratyaya sha, it means sixth gana only, it will get dummagama. So muchadigana is tudadigana, so only for these dhatus dummagama is ordained. So dummagama dhatava also done. If you see Jatapata, all the dhatus we have covered. Then comes the next one. I don't know whether you would have time for that. I think that also I will do it. Can I do for another 10 more minutes?
Yeah, I don't know.
There is one more gana is there in this Tudadi gana. You can see, I'll share that. One more antargana. One minute, I'll show you that.
Kutadayaha and Kiradayaha, is it?
Hmm?
Kutadayaha and Kiradayaha.
No, one more is there. It starts somewhere. Just a minute. Yeah, here it is. I think Tato is Trimp. Trimp dhatu. You see the dhatu? Trimp. Tripa ityasi sthane tripa iti patah api drishyate. Okay. So these are the dhatus. Trimp, then tump, etc. All these dhatus. That is 27. Dhatu starting from 27. I'll list down those dhatus. There are few dhatus under this. Trimpa, Thump, then Thump, Drimp. You see the screen now? My screen? No. Okay. 1 minute, I will share in the word file. You can see. Word file I'm sharing. Do you see the word file?
Yeah.
Trimp, Thump, then Thump, Drimp, Rimp, Gump, Womb, then Shumb, Trim. These are the dhatus. Okay, the dhatu is trimpa dhatu. Now you see the dhatu part. Trimpa, 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 triptau. The trimpa is there, that is a dhatu. Similarly, other dhatus which are listed down below. Okay, those dhatus I have written here in the word file. I just collected those dhatus and written in the word file these dhatus. These dhatus also, what we say is, these nine dhatus also, Kimbhavati, it will take Numagama. So these nine dhatus also will take, this by Vartikam, these nine dhatus will take Numagama. I will take one and then I will explain similarly for the other. These are not important dhatus, but still we will cover it. Trimpa dhatu plus sha plus tip. These dhatus, trimpa dhatu, which it means triptav, belonging to Tudadigana, will take Numagama. Will take Numagama. Already Num is there. Already Num is there. Where is Num? That Makara is there.
Yeah.
In the place of Makara, what was there before is Nakara. Because of Parasavarna becomes Makara. Right? So you have to understand that Trimp becomes Trimpa. Now, already Numagama is there. Then why do you say Numagama again? You see that Nakara, that Upada Nakara, followed by what Pratyaya? Followed by what Pratyaya? Followed by?
Sarvadhatuka.
Followed by a, it is followed by a Ngit Pratyaya, right?
Yeah.
Sarvadhatuka Mati Ngit Pratyaya. So, and here Nakara is there as part of the Dhatu, that Nakara, is it because of Idit Dhatu? Is a dhatu is idit dhatu?
No.
Therefore, this is anidit dhatu, right?
Yeah.
Idit dhatus are those dhatus where ikara is ita letter, because of which Numagama comes. Example.
Yeah, nindati.
Here, nidhi is, he is ita letter, because of which gets Numagama. Therefore, nindhi you get. Nindati, nindatah, nindanti. But here, the dhatu itself is trimp. Nakara is there as part of the dhatu, not a idit dhatu, right? Therefore, it is anidit dhatu. Anidit. Na idit, anidit. Nanchitat purusha samasa, right?
Yeah.
Now, anidit dhatu followed by a ngit pratyaya, then what will happen is dhatu ending with hal, having Nakara as its upada, that Nakara goes away. Nakara of Anidit Dhatu having Nakara should be the upada. Okay, the upada Nakara of Anidit Halanta Dhatu will become Lopa when followed by Nit Pratyaya. Let me write, then you will understand. Upada Nakara of important root. This you will see later many places. Of Anidit. Upada Nakara of Anidit Halanta Dhatu. I'm just putting it in a very short form. Everything. Halanta Dhatu will become Lopa. When? then followed by kit or nit. Upada nakara of anidit alanta dhatu will become lopa when followed by kit or nit pratyaya. Aniditaha alaha aniditaha, the rule is aniditaha alaha upadayaha niti. 6424, very important sutra. So that translation only are given. Translation of that, the sutra. Aniditam, that is anidit. And dhatu is halanta dhatu. Halanta dhatu having upada, nakara. The nakara is not born of the numagama, when the dhatu is idit. That's why anidit we say. So anidit halanta dhatu ho upada nakarasya lopah bhavati kada vena kitar nit pratyaya follows. You understand?
Yes, dear.
Yes.
Now, therefore, what will happen to the nakara of the dhatu will become lopaha, right? By applying this rule, see, I have written this rule very simply here. You can just see the translation. Upada nakara of anidit halanda dhatu will become lopaha when kitta nit pratyaya follows. So here, nit pratyaya follows. Therefore, nakara sekim bhavati, lopaha bhavati. Therefore, you get trip plus sha plus ti. Right? Understand?
Yes.
So therefore, what will happen? Vartika says the list of these dhatus will take numagama. Vartika says. There's a Vartika. That Vartika says Shetrumpadinam Upasankhyanam Kartavyam. I'll just write the Vartika here. Vartika is also a sutram only. She trimpadina, when she shakara, when sha pratyaya follows trimpadina. What are trimpadina? The dhatus which are listed below. Those are trimpadi dhatus. Trimpadi antargana. Dhatavaha, I have listed here. These are the trimpadi dhatu. These dhatus also to be enumerated. Upasankhyanam kartavyam. Vartika says upasankhyanam. These dhatus also should be enumerated for ordaining num agama when the pratyaya sha follows. Like muchadigana. Already num agama makara is, that nakara is there for all these dhatus. You can see the upada nakara is there. But the nakara goes away by this rule. Again, by the vartika, nakara is ordained. So what will happen now? Kimbhavati. Trim plus sha plus. It is trim. Pakara. So after that, nakara, pakara, you can do parasavarna. It will get makara, adesha, trimpa, trimpati. Again, back to trimpati. So it is back to the same one only. But this sutra to be applied, and then you have to ordain numagama by the vartika. So you have to follow this step. The step is step one. That if step one is upada nakarasya, Padanakarasya lopaha karaniyam. Number step two. Step two is ordain numagama vaidivartika. Ordain numagama. This is the step you have to follow. Why you remove numagama and then again you are ordaining? Because this sutra is applicable, very important. Upada nakara anidit dhatu will become lopaha. Because it becomes lopaha, therefore only this vartika is there. Understand? Is it clear?
Yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
miscarriage.
Yes.
So therefore, all the dhatus which have got nakara as its upada, the nakara not born of dhatu being an idit, therefore anidit dhatu, these dhatus when followed by nit pratyaya, nakarasya, upada nakarasya, all are alanda dhatu, therefore upada nakarasya, lopaha bhavati, and to these dhatus, by this vartika, numagama is ordained, therefore trumpati, tumpati, iti rupam bhavati. Right? With this, tudadigana is completed. So, maybe I can write this little further and I will send you this notes. You can go through that if you have any doubts. So, we'll stop here. You have any doubts? If you doubts, please clarify.
No,
okay. With the tudadigana is over. All the dhatus tudadigana we have covered. Okay. So first gana we have covered, fourth gana we have covered, then tudadigana also we have covered. Then churadigana we will see next class.
First gana we saw different sutras for upada nakara and upasharanji.
Please tell again.
In first gana we vadigana we have seen different sutras for upada nakara lopa.
What is that?
Yeah, that is Ranchesha and that Dhatu Ranch.
Dhatu?
Ranchesha, Ranch Dhatu.
Ranch Dhatu,
Ranch
yes.
Dhatu on there.
Yeah.
There Upadanakara Lopa happens.
Yeah, Upadanakara Lopa Bhavati, yes.
That, then one more Damsha Suncha.
Damsha, that's what I thought.
Yeah. Yes.
Ranjeshcha, that is upada nakara, yes, lopaha bhavati. That is, what is the condition? That is for shap pratyaya follows. This is for nit pratyaya follows.
That
is the difference. Good. You have to connect like that. Yes, very good. Ranjadhatu, which belongs to first gana, where shap pratyaya follows, then also becomes Lopaha, then Damshdhatu, Sanjdhatu, Swanjdhatu, all those dhatus where the Gana Vikrana Pratyaya is Shap, right? Then also, then Upadanakara Lopaha Bhavati. And this rule is 6420, I guess you have 6424, 6425, 6426, you can see. So, all these are Upadanakara Lopa related rules. This rule, this Anidit Dhatu, Upadanakara, that becoming Lopa 6424. After that 6425 is when Shap Pratyaya follows. Shap is not a Ngit Pratyaya, right? So even when Shap Pratyaya follows, that Nakara, Upada Nakara of Damsh Dhatu, Sanj Dhatu, Svanj Dhatu becomes Lopaha also for Ranj Dhatu. Yes, you're right. Those Dhatus belonging, those maybe belonging to the first Gana, Ranjit first Gana, that way Shap we say. Right? Shapi pare. Understand?
Yeah.
So, Damsh, you can summarize. Maybe in the next class I will do. The Upada Nakara Lopa happens for Anidit Dhatu followed by Nit Pratyaya. That is number one. Number two, also for the Dhatus, Damsh, Sanj, and Svanj. Then for the Ranj Dhatu, which followed by Shap Pratyaya, then also Nakara, Upada Nakara becomes Lopaha. You can ask me in the next class. I will just summarize this Upadanakara Lopaha. Okay. Fine. We'll stop here.
Yes, Sanji.
Okay. Or I'll copy that part from the Bhuvadigana. In Bhuvadigana, I think we have covered Ranjidhatu.
Yeah, right? We have.
Yes, that part I will copy. Yes.
Yeah. In Bhuvadigana also, we have written this again.
Huh?
In Divarigana also we have written this Upadaya. Yeah. Anidita Amphalaha.
Ah, yes.
So
that's why, I would have taught before. I don't remember what I taught you. So you must be remembering. And other classes and all I taught. I mean, in the Gurukulam class. So I'm a bit confused. Which class I taught? Which class I didn't teach? This Anidita Halaha, important sutra. I don't remember whether I taught you or not. You have to tell me whether you remember it.
Yeah, we have seen in the
fourth gana. Yes, we taught to you and you remember it. It's okay. It doesn't matter. Even if you don't, I take for granted always that you don't know. Then only I explain. If you know, it's good. If you don't know also, it's good because it is repeated again. So you don't miss it. But you please connect all the gana. These are related rules. You can connect and understand. As Ramaji told, it's very good. Upada, nakara, lopaha. You have to make your notes. When does upada, nakara, lopaha bhavati? One is when ngit pratyaya follows. Even when shap pratyaya follows, it happens where for these dhatus, four dhatus, damsh, sanj, svanj, and ranj dhatu. There also upadanakara lopaha bhavati. That's why you get ranjati, not ranjati. You get the form rajati.
Yeah, nakara.
Form is nakara lopa. Rajati you get. Yes. Okay. So we'll stop here. As I said, I'm traveling. So I'm trying to get internet from somewhere here and then take class. So we will continue karakam after I get back to Chennai. Okay. So next class also we will do the Tinganta, Churadigana we can take and do. So Tudadigana is over. I will add some more notes in this material and then I'll send you. We can go through that. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
Dhanyavada Khichi.
Fourth gana as well before.
Hmm?
That Grahi Jyavyayi, that also you have seen in the fourth gana.
Samprasaranam. Yes. Samprasaranam, as somebody said, I have sent a separate notes for the material for that. Samprasaranam related rules.
Dhanyavada.
Right.
Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada. Dhanyavada.